Hey guys, this is Reese. I'm one of the STIT interns this year with the Todd Becker Foundation. And did you know that 100% of every American worships something? Now, it may not be a little gold statue, but it might be fame, money, or even power. So who or what are you worshiping? Worship is so much more than just something we do, but it's how we live our life. Worship isn't just singing in church on a Sunday morning. Worshiping takes place everywhere almost all the time. So let me pose this question to you. Are you worshiping God or are you worshiping His creations? God so clearly states in the first two commandments, the first being, "You shall not have any gods before me," and the second being, "You shall not make any idols." So why is it when it comes to football games, or even being so invested into who's going to be the next American Idol, or we get so excited that some of us go out and paint our faces and buy a bunch of sports apparel, but on a Sunday morning, we just stand there with our hands in our pockets? We worship God's creation instead of God Himself. In Romans 1:25, it says, "They exchanged the truth about God for a lie, and worshiped and served created things rather than the Creator who is forever praised. Amen." We can't worship both God's creation and then God Himself. It is either one or the other. Luke 4:8 also says, "Jesus answered, 'It is written, worship the Lord your God and serve Him only.'" We are to worship only God and give Him praise only. So when we're out here going all out for the theme of the football game that night, and we go and buy these outfits and get all jacked up and crazy, and then again just stand there during church showing no emotion or excitement, we have to wonder, what am I worshiping? And I'd like to point out, I was that kid that always went all out for the theme nights and always excited about the game that night. So I know what it's like. And this verse right here is why I think it's so important to think about what we are doing with our lives. Romans 12:1 states, "Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship." What this verse is talking about is we should live in such a way that shows we worship God in everything we do all the time. And God being an all-powerful, all-knowing, omnipresent, and infinite God is so worthy of it. Psalms 96:4 says, "For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods." Just like I said at the beginning of the video, worship isn't something us Christians do, it's how we live our life. Over this next week, really reflect and ask God if you are truly worshiping God or is it His creations. If you have any questions about this or want to know more, please comment below. Thanks again, and we will see you next week.
If you want to learn more about this topic and many others, or about our cost-free STINT internship, visit toddbecker.org/stint.